global phenomenon. The most photographed woman in the world. Millions of pictures in thousands of publications taken by hundreds of photographers. Her face made many fortunes.
Sarah, do you remember her?
Anita Lavelle?
I grew up with her, you know. We were friends, I suppose. Then one day at her house, she told me.
I believe in a glamorous life.
Anita was infatuated by fame. The American dream. The idealistic, sensational star to whom she would soon become. A few years later, she moved to New York to pursue her career. She was playing gig in a little retro club on the Lower East Side when, boom, Charlie Lavelle, a.k.a. Mr. Big Shot Hollywood, signed her up for a few million quid. They married soon after that.
She may be the face I can't forget, the trace of pleasure or regret.
Coping with Charles.
I should have married him years ago.
Different things within the measure of a day.
The attention was phenomenal. Everybody wanted a slice. She was a good product. Sat on the shelf. Sold well. She knew it too.
We are nothing without our image, without our projection, without the spiritual hologram of who we perceive ourselves to be, or rather to become, in the future.
Il parle toujours avant moi et sa voix couvre ma voix.
And this is the fame. Love and Art, 12/18/1974.
She was utterly adored by the world, an idolized woman. Like most things, it was never going to last. The higher the media put you, the bigger the drop. Several years later, Anita arrived back from her world tour to find her label company hubby standing on her suitcase. I suppose he just couldn't take it. Her? The fame. Anita deserved to be alone. She wasn't long getting rid of me when Mr. Lavelle appeared with a dazzling deal to stardom.
What have you done? I worked so hard for you.
We had everything, and you blew it.
So, where is she now?
I don't know, Sarah. I heard she moved back to Ireland. But I don't know. I don't really care. She left me years ago, so I might as well leave her.